please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Every single village in India has access to electricity. That announcement coming from Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Saturday, this after a remote village in Manipur called Leezing became the last village to get access to power. It was in April 2015 that the government had identified 19,679 villages that did not have access to power. And 3 years later, the government has said mission accomplished. However, the government considers villages as electrified if only 10% of the village have access to power. So clearly, electrification of 100% of villages doesn't mean 100% of households are electrified. In fact, 18% of India's 18 crore households do not have last mile connectivity to the grid, that is 3.15 crore households. And what's worse, in many states, even people with grid connection and the power to pay suffer severe power cuts. So what then is the significance of this proclamation of 100% electrification? I'm shortly going to be joined by Power Secretary Ajay Kumar Bhalla on these and other issues. Give us some numbers to appreciate the scale of this achievement. Where were we, sir, say a year ago or say in 2014? What makes this achievement so grand?
See, I mean, these are the last mile villages, I should say, which where the electricity could not reach. Mm. In 2015, August, when Prime Minister announced that 18,452 villages are still left as reported by the state governments. Mm. So he gave us a time of 1,000 days to complete this task. Okay. Of course, it's a task which is jointly done in consultation with the state governments, and the implementing agencies are with the state government. Okay. And we could complete this task. Mm. There were some villages which are uninhabited, and there were some villages where, while during the work, some more villages were found which were not connected by grid or electricity. So all these have been finally 18,374 have been actually connected, and about 1,300 odd are the ones which were uninhabited.
Okay.
And out of this one thing, we have connected about 15,600 odd villages by grid and remaining by off-grid solutions, which are generally a solar solution.
All right. Fair point, sir. Now that is the size of the achievement. Let's now look at what is not achieved. Almost what, 20% or probably 18% that's not yet electrified. What is the game plan here?
17.99 crores are the total households, and 14.34 crores have been connected, and the remaining are about 3.65.
Yes.
Out of which, after launch of Saubhagya, we have connected about more than 50 lakh households.
Yes, sir.
So the number left is, yes, about 18% of total households in the country. But it's a very, achievable number. One shouldn't be looking at it that this is a very difficult number. Even in these villages, I come back to the villages with a little bit of issue that there were a lot of difficulties in connecting some of the villages.
Sure.
These were, as I said, the last mile. The achievement is not the numbers. Achievement is the difficulty under which these villages were connected. Some of these in Arunachal Pradesh are bordering Myanmar border, where we had to use helicopters for dropping the materials.
Yes.
Some villages in J&K, we had to take help of Air Force to drop the materials. And in Chhattisgarh's left-wing extremism areas, we had to find innovative ways to do the electrification. So that is the difficult part which we had to achieve. These 18,000 odd villages.
I'm not underplaying that achievement at
houses,
all, sir.
Of course, we are very much prepared. Sorry.
I get your point. In fact, I was reading out the data from the post-Saubhagya achievement numbers only. After deducting those 50 lakh households, we still have about 3.13 crore households which are not electrified.
Correct.
And you know, these are not all that inaccessible, sir. It is in Uttar Pradesh where the unelectrified houses are, you know, almost 45%, 44.14 to be precise.
Right.
It is in the state of Bihar where 26% are as yet unelectrified. Right. I can understand if it was Manipur. It is not, sir.
Yeah.
It is very much within striking distance from the capital. So what would be the game plan to be able to reach electrification to households now? I suppose that's the next threshold.
See, Already we have approached in the Sobhagya scheme a camp-based approach that camps should be held in a village or in cluster of villages depending on the population or the unelectrified households. And the connections should be released on the spot using the apps and all, which have already been developed and which are being used by the states, as Sobhagya scheme is already under implementation.
Absolutely.
So the connections are being released in big numbers. See, whenever a scheme starts, initially there are always teething troubles. By the time all the DISCOMs settle down with the work award, getting contracts in place, doing tendering, and setting up all the standards and other things, procurement of materials, etc. Once it gets into groove, the things move very fast. We have about 54 DISCOMs in the country, and all of them would be working and achieving this target. So, I mean, numbers may look in totality bigger. These number 3 crore odd numbers are in 30 states. So, I mean, there are DISCOMs in all the states, and each DISCOM has a big infrastructure down the line. If we look at one village every day, there'll be, I mean, each DISCOM can produce large numbers. Each division can produce large numbers.
But that is not the state of the DISCOM, sir. The state of the DISCOMs is the amount of power cuts and the amount of power thefts that they are still facing. Let me come to the cuts itself. You know, the cuts are extremely painful because behind every cut is a person willing to pay. It is demand backed by the capacity to pay, and still power is not being reached. Look at the numbers in March of 2018. It is 5 hours per month on a national average. And in certain states like Jharkhand, it is 45 hours in the month of March. In Haryana, it is 18 hours. I mean, Haryana is a rich state, and still 18 hours of power cuts in the month of March for those citizens. Clearly, this is a financial issue or a law and order issue that Haryana and Jharkhand are not able to tackle?
It is. It is, you see, there could be some local issues in supply of power and all. Now, get once we are out of numbers, so if you agree we achieve those numbers, then definitely we are looking at, under our different schemes, at the strengthening of infrastructure of rural electrification components, where Deendayal Upadhyaya Gram Jyoti Yojana has sanctioned a lot of money for these states. And we expect all those works to be completed during the year. The feeder separation is one of the important component of the Deendayal Upadhyaya Gram Jyoti Yojana. And these are the schemes which will implement the infrastructure, strengthen the, replace the conductors, replace the transformers wherever required, and strengthen the supply. There could be infrastructure constraints where the load shedding takes place, because 24/7 power supply should be available to each and every consumer.
Okay. Well, actually, let me come to theft, and then I'll go back to the new you know, rules put forth by the power minister. Power theft, sir, we still have Uttar Pradesh reporting as of March 2018, 35% in power theft. I mean, no DISCOM will be able to make 65% of the population pay for 100%. If, and 35%, I'm sure, is not getting stolen by the poorest and the weakest, but usually by people who have the capacity to pay and therefore the capacity to steal. I mean, how does one address this problem? Is the Central Power Ministry even talking to the Uttar Pradesh government? It is the same party in power.
Very much, very much. I mean, why not? I mean, we definitely review all the state governments every month. And this is an important issue. You see, I mean, Uday scheme had one major important thing, was the billing efficiency should be increased. Now, this is the place where the billing efficiency has to be, that's the only thing to, you check the theft. Now, Uttar Pradesh has engaged one of our company called ESL and has placed order for large number of meters to be installed. Uttar Pradesh problem, perhaps in some areas, well, there were no meters. If there are no meters, there is a lot of theft and all. So once these meters get installed, the things will improve.
Now, finally, my question is on, you know, the surplus power that is available. Many of these are not being purchased. We know that PLFs have actually dropped by a percentage point over the past year. We are not seeing an improvement in capacity utilization. And many of these plants in the next 4 months could actually be marched to the NCLT because they are not viable units. You know, KSK Ventures or many of the GMR, GVK plants, the Ratan India plant. I could go on with the number of plants that could be marched to the NCLT. Is there a plan to ensure that this power plants are saved somehow and these plants are made viable?
Yeah. See, again, the capacity utilization of the PLF factor, has, if it has declined, it has touched 60%. I think last time I mentioned that.
Yes.
It's on the up. One thing, in absolute number, there has been a growth in power consumption. There is a growth, very regular growth,
yes,
of about 4.45%. Growth is there. So we expect this growth. Now, because the large capacity had come in, so the overall PLF looks to be little lower. Now, I mean, DISCOMs have to improve their finances. They have to improve the metering system so that the demand stabilizes, demand picks up, and all these power plants come into this thing. Definitely, the stressed power plants are being looked at. I mean, one set of reforms on coal linkage side was already done, which would have helped about 10,000 megawatts.
Okay.
Other bankers are looking at.
Okay.
Within the present norms of restructuring, which is as per the new RBI circular, SBI is taking a lead and is looking at some of the projects which can be taken care of by...
Okay, did you hear from
form
the
of restructuring?
I thought the power minister was asking for some changes in the rules. Did you hear from the RBI?
No, we have not heard anything from the RBI. We are looking forward to a meeting with them. And once a meeting takes place, because the Association of Power Producers have raised some issues with us, which we have communicated to RBI, asking them to look at it. And we are looking forward to a meeting with them.
Okay, well, I don't want to take away from the achievement of the of our country in terms of reaching power to the last village recently. Every Indian village is electrified. What is the next big goal that the government has given you, given the power ministry, Mr. Bhalla?
See, presently, in from 14th April onwards, we are working on Gram Swaraj Abhiyan, where seven government of India schemes are being put in, identified 20,000 odd villages for saturation purposes. I have two schemes from power ministry. One is Ujala, the distribution of LED bulbs. And other is Sobhagya, the saturation of connections in these 20,000 odd villages.
Okay.
So we are already working on it as a immediate term, but which is a target on my hand.
Yes.
And secondly, of course, we are looking at Sobhagya scheme to be completed not only up to March 19, but we are trying to target it within December 18. So that in any case, and I mean, that is a stage, if even one house is left unconnected, we'll have some time to connect to the remaining houses.
That's definitely good news for the country. Thank you very much for joining us, Mr. Bhalla. So it's every village electrified as of now, and before the calendar year runs out, probably is going to be every household. If we can really achieve that goal, that's a significant achievement for the country and for the government. We are celebrating the fact that the last of India's village in the state of Manipur was electrified over the weekend, and India now, village-wise, is 100% electrified. But as we just heard the power secretary say, in terms of households, there are still 3.13 crore households, or 18% of India, still unconnected to traverse the ground not yet covered. I have with me Vinayak Chatterjee of Feedback Ventures, of Feedback Infra, and former power secretary, Mr. P. Umashankar. Gentlemen, thank you very much for joining me. Well, we just heard the government voice, so let me get the private sector first. Vinayak, assess the achievement for us. Is it grave? Is it a resounding achievement to have electrified every village? Or is it that not electrifying 18% of our households is still a very big black mark?
Look, the process of reaching every rural household needs to be broken into three steps. First, you bring the power to the village level. Next, you achieve connecting households, institutions, shops, establishments.
Yes.
And stage three, even after connecting, you see that the connected house or institution, the customer, is fully serviced in terms of the professional metering billing collection.
Yes.
So we have to look at the process three stage wise. What we have achieved is 100% of stage one, which is commendable, because this kind of focus, honestly, this should have been achieved maybe 20 years after we got independence. This should have been achieved by 1960 or so.
Yes.
The fact that it has taken so long is certainly a major embarrassment for a country of the size and stature of India. But the fact that this government has given it such high priority and achieved this is, I think, extremely commendable and a historic landmark. But let me stop here.
Okay. Well, Mr. Umashankar, let me come to you with another issue. You know, now we are talking about households that do not have electricity and to whom electricity is going to be reached. And God willing, we should be able to achieve it by March 2019. The power sector, deadline has been pushed forward, actually, to December 2018. Maybe, you know, 90% of that is going to be achieved. But what is even more embarrassing is that we are still losing so much to power theft. In the state of Uttar Pradesh, like I had just said, 35% of the power is still lost to AT&C as of March 2018. Lower from 40% a year ago, but still 35%. In fact, in the state of Maharashtra, power theft, which was 20% in March 2017, has risen to 22% in March 2018. Your thoughts on that? Haven't we even got law and order in place?
If you look at some of the efforts that have been made in reducing power theft, which comes under the overall umbrella of AT&C losses, you'll find that Uday is one scheme which is attempting that.
Yeah.
There is one more scheme which was done prior to that, which is the financial restructuring.
Mm.
What one found was that in both these programs, the first part of the program, which is to rid the discounts of huge loans that they've taken,
yes,
and take them off their balance sheet and onto somebody else's balance sheet, was done easily.
That's true.
But the other steps in terms of reducing AT&C losses or improving the gap between receipts and expenditure,
yes,
that could not be done or was not been done to an extent in most of the states. These are two crucial things, like you mentioned, AT&C loss is a very crucial thing which needs to be attempted at by every state, and it is not easy at all. And the second point that I'd like to say is that even the figures that we are talking about now, or 35% or 25%, quite often these figures are also very doubtful.
Oh, okay.
If they are really 25%, or is it some kind of a financial exercise which has come to these figures?
Okay,
that is something that is doubtful.
Mm.
One attempt that was made through that restructured, accelerated, development program was to see that at least in towns, the supply of electricity, the billing of electricity, and so the total that was supplied and the total that was collected, that should
match.
Be on an electronic basis, and so that there is cannot be no manipulation, and the figures available to you would be authentic.
Okay,
that was attempted. That, of course, is still work in progress.
Yes, I agree.
That at least will show you some, real figures of what exactly is going on.
I mean, we are here speaking about people who have the ability to pay and who are demanding power, and we are not supplying power, even as we have so many power plants craving for usage, craving for power purchase agreements. The national PLF is standing, plant load factor is standing at 60%, which means we're using only 60% of available power capacity. Vinayak, how do you react to this? On the one hand, several plants will be marched to the NCLT because they are not viable. On the other hand, look at the load shedding. I mean, for the state of Jharkhand, it went without power for 45 hours in the month of March. For the state of Haryana, it went without power for 18 hours. This means there were people ready to pay and wanting power, and we were not supplying, although we had plants with excess capacity.
So, Lata, we have discussed this point, you and I, almost for a decade.
Yes.
And I will repeat my point that most discussions in the power sector have to do with generation, whereas the reality on the ground is that it is the distribution sector that wags, it is the tail that wags the dog. This tail is horribly emasculated. In India, the problem with power sector in India has nothing to do with generation. It has nothing to do with fuel supply. It is ultimately decades, 3 to 4 decades of emasculation, of political blindsiding, of corruption, of lack of attention to the distribution sector, which has pulled down the entire nation with the kind of AT&C loss figures, which even sir has said are doubtful. So a concerted attack on distribution has still not been attempted. What has been attempted under Uday is a financial restructuring that does not attack the underlying issues which I just mentioned.
Yep.
So over time, I don't think we have enough time today, but you know my views about what kind of surgical strike is required on the distribution sector, but more on that whenever you have time.
All right. I'm sorry we are out of time, Mr. Umashankar and Vinayak. Thank you very much for joining me. A great milestone today that every village has been electrified, but the goals yet to be achieved, 3.13 crore households to be electrified hopefully by the end of this calendar year or financial year, and an even more important milestone, people with the ability to pay for power not getting it, and therefore load shedding, that should be the next frontier we have to attack. Thank you very much for joining us in this special discussion, Powering Up.